Hello friends and dear students. Today's topic in the Viva course of anatomy is mid-sagittal section of head and neck. In this topic, we will divide this topic in the four regions, that is the oral cavity, nasal cavity, the pharynx and the larynx. Now we will start with the oral cavity. Oral cavity will contain the two main organs, that is the fan-shaped organ, that is tongue, and the soft palate. In the tongue, you can see one muscle, that is the genioglossus, that will arise from the superior genial tubercle of the mandible up to the tongue. It is a fan-shaped muscle and it is a safety muscle of the tongue. The second muscle that is arising from the inferior genial tubercle to the hyoid bone, that is the geniohyoid muscle. You have to remember the nerve supply of the tongue, that can be asked in the Viva also. The second is the soft palate. But before that, above the tongue you can see the hard palate, after that there is a soft palate, and you have to remember the nerve supply of the soft palate also. Now the second part in the mid-sagittal section of head and neck, that is the nasal cavity, it is divided into three parts. The first one anteriorly, that is the nasal vestibule. The second posterior to it is a respiratory region, and above the respiratory region there is an olfactory region. Now the nasal vestibule will contain the hair follicle and the hair that will prevent the minor dust particle into the nasal cavity. The olfactory region is covered by the olfactory mucosa. The function of it is to carry the smell sensation. And the third, we will concentrate on the respiratory region. Now it will contain the three concha, that is the bony projection, that is the superior, middle and the inferior. Inferior concha is a separate bone, and the superior and the middle concha are the part of an ethmoidal bone, projection of the ethmoidal bone. Now the space beneath all three concha are called as a meatus, and the important openings present in the each meatus. We will starting with the inferior meatus that lies beneath the inferior concha. The opening of the nasolacrimal duct will open into the inferior meatus. Second, middle meatus, that is beneath the middle concha. It will contain the first, the bulla ethmoidalis. Beneath the bulla ethmoidalis, you will have the opening of middle ethmoidal air sinus. Above the bulla ethmoidalis, you will have the hiatus semilunaris, in which there is an opening of frontal air sinus anteriorly, anterior ethmoidal air sinus in the middle part, and posteriorly maxillary air sinus. Now below the superior concha, you will have the superior meatus, in which there is only one opening, that is the posterior ethmoidal air sinus. Third part in the sagittal section of the head and neck, that is the pharynx. Pharynx is a fibromuscular tube which is extend from the base of the skull above up to the esophagus below. There are three parts of the pharynx. The part, first part that lies behind the nasal cavity, that is known as a nasopharynx. Behind the oral cavity, that is known as a oropharynx, and behind the laryngeal cavity, that is known as a laryngopharynx. We will see the first part of the pharynx, that is the nasopharynx, the part of a pharynx that lies behind the nasal cavity. The first is a nasopharyngeal tonsil, that is the aggregation of the lymphoid follicle in the roof of a nasopharynx. Here lies the nasopharyngeal tonsil. Now the enlargement of the nasopharyngeal tonsil is known as adenoids, which is common in the children. The second feature in the lateral wall of nasopharynx is an opening of a auditory tube or ustichial tube. In relation to this opening, you can see the two fold. The one fold is anterior, that is from the opening to the soft palate, that is known as a salpingo-palatine fold, that is formed by the muscle of the same name. The second fold posteriorly, that is the salpingopharyngeal fold, from this opening to the pharyngeal wall, salpingopharyngeal fold, that is also formed by the muscle of the same name. Now behind this salpingopharyngeal fold, you can see the deep recess. This is known as a pharyngeal recess. The second part of the pharynx is the oropharynx, that is the cavity of the pharynx behind the oral cavity that will extend from the subpalate above up to the epiglottis below. This one is a oropharynx. Now we will see the feature in the lateral wall of the oropharynx. The first one is a palatine tonsil. The palatine tonsil is an aggregation of a lymphoid follicle that is lies between the two fold. One is a palatoglossal fold, and second posterior is a palatopharyngeal fold. Here lies the palatine tonsil. The second, in the anterior wall of the oropharynx, in the posterior one third of the tongue, you can see also the aggregation of the lymphoid follicle, that is known as a lingual tonsil. Behind this posterior one third of the tongue, in the oropharynx, you can see the epiglottis. In the epiglottis, you can see the two fold in the section. Actually, there are three fold in the whole part, but here you can see the two fold, that is the median glossoepiglottic fold and lateral glossoepiglottic fold. And the fossa between these two fold is known as a valicula. Now the third part in the pharynx is a laryngopharynx. That is the cavity lies behind the laryngeal inlet. This is the laryngeal inlet. Behind it you will have the laryngopharynx. Now in the lateral wall of a laryngopharynx you can see one fossa that will extend around the larynx also anteriorly. This is known as a pyriform fossa. Now the last part in the sagittal section is the larynx. The larynx will extend from the laryngeal inlet above up to the trachea below. Now we will see the feature in the lateral wall of the larynx. The lateral wall will show mainly the two fold, the upper and the lower fold. The upper fold is known as a vestibular fold or the false vocal cord that is formed by the vestibular ligament. The lower fold is known as a vocal fold or true vocal cord that is formed by the vocal ligament. Now this two fold divide this part, lateral part, into three subdivisions. The part above the vestibular fold, that is from the epiglottis up to the vestibular fold, this area is known as a vestibule. The part between these two fold is known as a ventricle of a larynx. And the part below the vocal fold or provocal cord is known as an infraglottic part. Now the second thing, the area between the two vestibular fold, right and the left, is known as a rima vestibuli. And the area between the two vocal cord is known as a rima glottidis. Now the larynx will contain total 9 cartilage. Out of these 9 cartilages, 3 are unpaired and 3 are paired. The 3 unpaired cartilages are epiglottis cartilage, thyroid cartilage and cricoid cartilage. Whereas the paired cartilages are arytenoid cartilage, corniculate cartilage and cuneiform cartilage.
If you like our video, like it, subscribe it and share with your friends.